Hi, my name is Cameron Carlson with AnimeLocation.tv. I'm here at Ohayocon 2020 with Mr. Jason Lee. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Great to be here.
Alrighty, so it's been a long time since we got the chance to talk to you. How have you been since then? In about, I would say, almost 20 years.
I've been on my mountaintop, just in a little hut in Yemen, and just hanging there, you know, chilling. What the, you know, is that what the kids say? Chilling? It's not that I retired from anime. I just, you know, there's a lot of life things that happen, and you go in different directions, so, yeah.
Alrighty, so it's been you were at the Ohayocon roast this year. Do you remember what was it like when the original roasts were taking place way back in the early days?
I do, actually. I started on stand-up comedy. That was my whole background. And then I kind of also did anime and voice acting and video games. And when I got invited to roast my wife, Amanda Windley, I was like, oh, I'm doing this. And I wasn't going to just tell funny stories. I was going to obliterate the room. And I did, and I was vicious and brutal and sexual and disgusting, and now that's all everyone does. Like, apparently I set some sort of mini trend, so it's fun, you know? I mean, that's kind of what, to me, what a roast is, and everybody's mean, but you know, it's pretty much out of love, mostly, you know? So, but yeah, I mean, that roast is like, I thought I brought my game, and people just brought their A game over me big time. So it was fun. It was a lot of fun.
See, the problem is when you roast, you have to go home to the person you roasted.
Right.
So now you're very supportive of your wife and her YouTube channel and her causes. What does it mean for you to see her succeed in a very tough environment?
You know, I guess we're succeeding on YouTube. We have the subscribers and all that kind of stuff. It's what's great about our, we actually produce it. I do all the editing and that stuff, and she's the talent, she's the writer and the driver of all, everything, but she's kind of become a big advocate. But can I mention the channel?
Sure.
It's a Mom's Guide to Cannabis, and it's basically about destigmatizing cannabis, you know. It's actually an educational channel that I just make fun and silly, because most channels on YouTube are bunch of stoners going, dude, this is da-da-da-da, you know, and ours is just like a interstitial show, or like the Daily Show, kind of just dumb graphics and informative stuff and make it fun. But also, I mean, to destigmatize it, we had a great panel last night, Mom's Guide to Cannabis panel. People were just asking real questions. So it's great to educate, and it's kind of less important that we monetize, more important that we educate and turn it into something that's just takes it down a notch for the whole world, you know.
Yeah. Now, speaking of which, at one time you played opposite your wife in the crazy series called Dead Leaves.
Oh,
take us through that. What was it like working on that project? Because I remember watching that and I'm like, do I need to be high to enjoy this, or is this just really trippy, period?
It helps both. Yes, my wife chimed in over there. It helps to be high, but it is really like a mind trip. It's just a nonstop bang, 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 bang. And we produced that for, it was manga. We produced it for manga. And originally, here's the thing, like, we started our production company back then. And I mean, my wife's talented. I would cast her in everything. I didn't want to cast myself in everything. Oh, hey, this is for me. So I'm not going to mention it. We had cast somebody else in the role because I'm like, no, I do not want to do the lead role. And just after a couple of days, we realized he just didn't have it in his head what that role should be. And she goes, you have to do it. And I did it. And I just left my brain and became a spaz. And it was, you know, it literally was just like, bam, bam, here all the time. That's essentially what retro is, you know. And it's just nonstop, like, assault to the senses. That's all it is. You know, I know there's a storyline, but that's a storyline.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy.
Yeah.
So anyway, I don't know. I don't. That was probably as nonsensical as the whole show was, you know.
Yeah. So now, again, you're still editing in film now from time to time. Take us through that work. What work would a fan potentially get to see that you've edited?
If you like stuff that old people like, you probably watch what I watch. No, I mainly do. I mean, I've done some film. I did a documentary called What We Carry, which is the more depressing part of my answer, and it's about Holocaust survivors who, and you can kind of find that online, but you got to search for it because it was never officially released. It was actually a educational tool they originally were going to take to schools and stuff, but then they turned it into a film. I edited part of that, not the whole thing, part of it. Mainly what I edit is you can, if you watch the new season of East True Hollywood Stories, that trash, I did that. And they don't care. There's a thing called Listing Impossible. I do like a lot of cable television. I used to work on The Doctor, so that was network. But, you know, it's, if you look at my IMDb page or my LinkedIn page, it'll pretty much have an updated list of credits. But it's essentially basic cable, you know. But it really pays the bills. It's great, you know. Yeah. So.
Alrighty, now you have now been in the industry for well over two decades. Can you tell us one of the biggest changes you've seen since you started?
I mean, essentially, it's enormity. Like, we started going to cons in the 90s, and, you know, they were little affairs. Anime Iowa, which, you know, had probably 2,000 people, and I don't know how many people this has. But
so they were expecting potentially over the weekend 23,000, which is, like, one of the highest numbers they've ever had.
Wow. Yeah, that's what it felt like. Yesterday, I was just walking through going, coming down here in the elevator, every elevator was full, and we just went, nope, we're going in this one, squeezing in every nook and cranny. I mean, it's great. It just makes fandom, it gives everyone a place to come and be like-minded, and it's just the enormity of it, and it's more people now. It's not just Fringe. It's all, it's very mainstream. My son's, we haven't seen him all weekend. He's in the gaming room all weekend. So, and we know he's safe. That's a kind of cool thing about it, you know?
Yeah, just drop Noodle off there. He'll be fine. Yeah,
exactly. Yeah. That's his name, nickname Noodle. And I don't think he likes it, but that's what we've called him since he was a child. So, you know.
Alrighty. Now, are there any upcoming projects you can talk about that aren't behind the pesky NDA wall?
Well, we're still doing Mom's Guide to Cannabis. We've actually took a break because we had some, a little bit of tragedy that we had. We're just like, you know, there are times you take a break. But I filmed last night our panel. I'm going to put a new episode of that out. Amanda will talk about her projects coming up. She does a lot more industry-based anime, video game stuff. I don't do it as much anymore. There's a time aspect where I'm editing a TV show right now. I guess I can talk about called Bargain Mansions. Once again, HDTV type stuff. So that'll be coming out sometime probably in the spring. So that's all I have.
Alrighty, now, we know that you don't really have a great social media presence, but if there was a potential for it, where could we follow you? And a message you'd like to give to the fans after over 20 years of being in the industry?
I don't have a huge social media presence. I'm very much a social media hermit. My Facebook page is private because the internet's awful. Like after the roast the other day, Rob Mungle texted me, goes, dude, we're getting attacked by this dude on Twitter. I go, I'm not on Twitter, so it doesn't matter. I have a website for mainly my editing projects, jasonleeeditor.com, but that just kind of, and I'll update that, but that's just more of a demo for my work. But sorry, guys, I'm not a guy that interacts much because it's about time, really. And you know, the internet is awful. So, no, it's great. You guys are lovely, but don't be awful. All right, that's all I have.
All righty, thanks for coming out with me and joining me, Jason. Thank you so much.